Dear students, in this video, we are going to study about procedure, a rule of export and import of custom duty that is called as baggaging. So what is the meaning of baggages? What are the rules related to baggages? Right. So those all things we'll see in today's class. The term baggage means luggage of the passenger, and it refers to all dutiable goods imported by a passenger or a member of crew in the baggage. Okay, in simple, baggage means a luggage, right? A luggage of the passenger, which you are importing it from the other countries, and it refers to all the dutiable goods. Okay, the dutiable goods, all the goods which are coming under the orbit of custom duty. And these imported by a passenger, it can be imported by a passenger who is coming to India, right? There such goods which is having a luggage, that is called as baggage. Similarly, if passenger is not bringing the goods, or a member of a crew in the baggage, in his baggage, right? The member of a crew, the member of the ship, or a member while in the aircraft or aeroplane, they will bring certain luggage. That is called as a baggage. So what is the statutory meaning? As per Section 2, Subsection 3 of Custom Act 1962, baggage includes accompanied baggage, but does not include motor vehicles. Okay, so baggage, it includes all kind of things, right, which are included in luggage, which are dutiable. So such thing are called as accompanied baggage, but as per Section 2, Subsection 3, it does not include motor vehicles. If anybody is bringing any kind of motor vehicles as the luggage, so those things are not called as baggage. Okay. Now, so accompanied means the baggage not carried by the passenger at the time of arrival, but sent before or after arrival of passenger. See, there are some baggage which a person will receive it, or he will be receiving in the future. Right, he will come before, right, by airplane. Then the baggage will be coming by ship in some container. Or the baggage will come before, after that he will arrive at the particular port. So such kind of a baggage, where the baggage, the baggage not carried by a passenger at the time of his arrival. When he is arriving in India, when he is coming into India, the goods are not imported at the same time. The baggage will be imported at some before his arrival, or after, or it can be after arrival of a passenger. So such are called as accompanied baggage. Similarly, on the basis of the provision of Custom Act, the baggage can be classified as follows. Means they are classified as two broad categories. First is applicable goods, and second is non-applicable goods. Okay, first is applicable goods, and second is non-applicable goods. Applicable goods are those which are all dutiable goods, which are provided under Custom Act, which are regulated by Custom Tariff Act, and which are all dutiable goods, which are all permitted by goods, permitted by Custom Act, and all taxable under those things. Now, non-applicable goods are those which are like non-dutiable. Or these are the goods which are not provided under particular Custom Tariff Act as well as Custom Act. Now, these non-applicable goods are again sub-classified into three types. First is motor vehicles, alcohol drinks, and goods imported through courier. So these three things are not covered under the non-applicable or applicable goods. Motor vehicle, as we know, because when you are having a motor vehicle or bringing a motor vehicle, there is a separate kind of calculation will be made. It is not treated as a kind of a baggage. not treated as a kind of a goods by the custom authorities. Okay, so these are separate. So these are non-applicable goods under baggage. Now, similarly, alcohol drinks. If anybody is, first of all, alcohol drinks is not permitted by custom duty. You cannot bring alcohol. You cannot carry alcohol in the aeroplane because for the safety reasons. Anytime, like if the uncertainty might happen, like some problem in the aircraft can happen or severe problems may happen. So they don't allow, first of all, alcohol. But even if it is allowed at some extent, but those are not dutiable goods. Okay. Because that is again covered under separate heads. Then goods imported through courier. Now, some of the goods are there where they are providing some international courier. Okay, internationally. Like in India, we have some couriers like professional courier or some other courier. Now, some goods are there which you imported, but you received it in India. And those are the baggage of that courier company, not for you. Right? That courier company which is importing the goods, for them, that is a baggage. Because you are using the services of a courier. For you, it is not a directly non-applicable goods. Okay, so these are three types under that. And when you bring the goods, they are classified as red and green channel. Red and green channel. There are two channels. It is imparticipable to ask every passenger to declare the contents of his baggage in details, right? For this purpose, two channels are provided as green and red channel, right? When baggage is like the authorities, custom authorities will ask you to have a declaration or ask you to fill the content in the declaration, the baggage will contain or the form will contain two channels. First is the green channel and second is the red channel. Okay, the applicant or the passenger, he need to declare it, right? He is asked by the custom authority to fill whether green channel is applicable and or red channel is applicable. Now, what is green channel? If a person does not have any dutiable goods, he can go through green channel without undergoing any check along with the baggage. Okay, if he has anything called as a person who does not have any dutiable goods, the goods are not dutiable. So in that case, when the goods are not dutiable, he can go through green channel. Like when you travel, you will find a signal. And when you see a green light, it shows that you should move forward, right? You can go. Similarly, the green channel, whenever you are filling it in the form, you are applying it that you want to go through green channel. That means your goods are the goods, whatever you are having, any like dutiable goods are there. He can go through green channels and without undergoing any check along with the baggage. There's no required to go for check under a baggage. Okay, now suppose he has applied as a red channel. If the person is carrying a dutiable goods, right? These goods are dutiable, means on this he has to pay a custom duty. So he should pass through red channel and should submit the declaration and his baggage can be inspected by the custom authorities. So now custom authorities will inspect it. Suppose he is bringing some gold, right? Some sort of gold, or he is bringing some mobile phones or some other things. Now these all things will come under dutiable goods. So he has to declare it that he has a dutiable goods and he has to pass through the red channel and should submit the declaration. The declaration will be inspected by the some authorities, custom authorities. Then they will allow you to go for a further process. Okay, so these are green and red channel. Now it may be noted that if a person adopts green channel, like sometimes you will adopt a green channel, technically, it is declaration that he is not carrying any dutiable goods. It means to carry dutiable goods and going through a green channel with cantonment to false declaration and the person may be penalized. Okay, sometimes what happens, like a person, he has a dutiable goods. is coming from some other country, he is having a dutiable goods, means on that particular goods he has to pay a custom duty. So red channel is applicable, but to avoid the duty, to avoid the custom tariff, what he will do, he will, in declaration he will tell that he don't have any dutiable goods, right? He has a goods which are non dutiable, so he will try to pass from green channel. But the custom authority, if they find that he has some dutiable goods, and when they did some inspection they found that there is certain gold there, or there was some mobile phone, or there was some other things like laptop or whatever things we are having. Now these all things, when they found it, those are dutiable goods, right? Though he will be penalized depending upon the severity, depending upon the number of things he has bought. So depending upon case, the penalty will be there. In some cases the penalty will be just monetary penalty, and in some cases the penalty will be like he can be sent behind bars also. Like different country have a different rules and regulation, right? Some country have very strict rules and regulation. Immediately one such kind of person is found, they will directly take him to jail, and from there he has to pay the penalty also, as well as he has to stay in the jail for so many days. Okay, so this is about red and green channel in the baggage. Now what is the statutory provisions related to baggage? The statutory provisions relating to baggage are covered by section 77 to 81 of the Custom Act, right? The compulsory and statutory provision, whatever are there, these are covered under section 77 to 81 of the Custom Act. What it says, the first declaration by the owner of baggage, this is said in section 77. These all are the very important rules, right, which are statutory, mandatory. So the first rule is declaration by the owner of baggage. The owner of the baggage shall make a declaration of its content to the proper officer of the customs for the purpose of clearing it. This is known as baggage declaration form. The declaration of packaging list is sufficient declaration. Okay, as per section 77, right, this is a mandatory and statutory provision. It provides that, it says that the owner of the baggage, the person who is the owner of baggage, he shall make a declaration, right? The declaration generally will, they will take you in writing, or they will be having one form, declaration, baggage declaration form. In that baggage declaration form, you need to write all the contents in that, and then after writing the contents, you should write that whether you are eligible for dutiable goods, or whether the things what you are carrying, those are not dutiable goods. And when it is mentioned, that will be sufficient declaration, and that will go for your second step. Okay, then rate of duty and tariff valuation in respect of baggage, this is said in section 78 of Custom Act. So the rate of duty and tariff valuation, if any applicable to the baggage, shall be the rate of and valuation in force on the date on which declaration is made in respect of such baggage under section 77. Okay, see, when you make that, you are having a dutiable goods in the form number one, in the declaration, baggage declaration form. Then if you say you are a dutiable goods, you need to know about the rate of duty and the tariff valuation, right? And if you declared that you are having non-dutiable goods, then second form will not come at all. Now when you made a dutiable goods, then in that case, the declaration, whatever you made in section 77, that will be applicable. In that case, what will be the rate? The rate of duty on the baggage is 35%, right? Plus 10% social welfare charges. Thus, effective rate is 38.5. Actually, they might be charging more also. So the effective rate of the duty baggage is 38.5%. The following points are noteworthy in this record. What are those? If relevant date is prior to 2/2/2018, the baggage duty is increased by education cess and secondary and higher education cess at 3%. In this case, the effective rate is 36.5%. 05. Okay, so like it differs again. Generally, the baggage is 35%, social welfare is 10%, but with effect from February 2018, effective rate is 38.5%. Generally, they are charging on the goods. Now see, similarly, not applicable. The rate of 35% duty is not applicable to. On which cases this 35% is not applicable? Firearms. Okay, if anybody has bought a firearms. Firearms actually bringing in the export or import, that is totally not permitted at all. If anybody is bringing it, it is not just avoided, it is a criminal activity also. Okay, firearms. Then if government is bringing, suppose government, they want any kind of firearms from the different countries. If they have bought, then in that case, these are like the rate of duty, 35% duty is not applicable there. Then cartridges for firearms exceeding 50. Right? Some cartridges, some bullets, right, for firearms, which is exceeding 50, somebody has bought from some other countries. Right, when country is bringing, when armed forces they are bringing, these are duty free. When our army is bringing any cartridges, if it is required from USA, Russia, so these are like duty free. Cigarettes, cigars, tobacco, in the excess of the quantity prescribed for the importation free of duty under the relevant baggage rules. Okay, somebody is bringing any cigarette or a cigar or a tobacco up to some limit. Okay, up to some limit, it is permitted. But beyond that limit, if anybody is bringing, it is again like liable for a duty. Then goods imported through a courier services, right? You're bringing any goods, you're importing it by some help of the courier services. Now for you, it might not be like a baggage. For the courier service who are importing the goods for them, that good will be treated as a baggage. So laptop exemption. The central government has exempted one laptop computer when computer imported into India by a passenger of the age of 18 years or above from whole of BCD. Okay, baggage custom duty. So if you are bringing any laptop, you found that some good high definition laptop is there with the latest features, and you bought a laptop from outside India. Till one laptop, you can bring it from outside India, right? Or you can book computer also. You can buy a computer or a laptop. But the condition they have said is the person should be above 18 years. And the passenger can bring, the member of the crew, like the member of the aircraft, the member of the ship, they can't bring this. Only the passenger who is above 18 years, he can bring one laptop, which is not applicable for the duty or which is exempted one, right? Without duty also, he can bring it. Only thing is that he need to have a bill or a vouchers, whatever is there, should be submitted to the custom authorities. Then duty exemption to baggage, which is said in section 79. Section 79, subsection 1 of the Custom Act refers to the duty relief available in respect of baggage. It stipulates that the proper officer may subject to baggage rules pass free of the duty. Okay, there are certain things where these are duty free or duty relief available. So some relief will be provided on the particular baggage duty. It's not completely duty free. It is not absolutely duty. So there is some relief provided as per section 79. So any article in the baggage of a passenger or a member of the crew in respect of which the said officer is satisfied that it has been in his use for such a minimum period as many be specified in the rules. Okay, so this is a rule pass free of a duty when any article is there which you bought in the baggage. Who is bringing it? Either a passenger or a member of a crew. And where an officer is satisfied,
right, by seeing your goods, he is satisfied. And he found that the use of minimum trade, as many may be specified in the rules, as per rules, if it is satisfied, then any article in the baggage of the passenger, in respect of which the officer is satisfied that it is for the use of the passenger or his family, or a bona fide gift or souvenir provided provident that value of each such article and the total value of all such article does not exceed such limits as may be specified in the rule. Okay, he is bringing anything as a gift. The passenger is taking that as a gift to his family members, to his parents. In that case, if the officer is satisfied with that, then on those things also there will be relief provided. Thus, the category of baggage, namely those belonging to passengers, member of the crew, right? These two people generally, they take the benefit of this. Similarly, it envisages three classes of goods: personal effect, which has been in the use of the person for a minimum period, right? He is personally, he is using it. It's minimum effect or a minimum period it is required. Household effect, which is not buying for his own use, but for family members, right? Like for his father, mother, sister. So that way. Third is that instead of personal and family members, he want to gift or gifts or souvenirs. That means central government has told that to make rules of this purpose, it carry out the provision of section 79. These are called as baggage rules and have been discussed in a separate para in this particular unit. But in these three things, it is mainly not applicable if it is bought for personal effect, household effect, or gifts or souvenirs. Next is temporary detention of baggage, which is said in section 80. So a baggage of a passenger contains, if any article which is dutiable or imported, of which is prohibited, and in respect of which a true declaration has been made under section 77, the proper officer may, at the request of the passenger, detail such article for the purpose of being returned to him on leaving India, and for any reason the passenger is not able to collect the article at the time of leaving India, the article may be returned to him through any other passenger authorized by him and leaving India, or a cargo consigned in his name. Okay, if any person is there who, while importing any goods or declaring the goods, he imported the goods which is prohibited, and in respect of which he has even made a true declaration also, but the officer wise has not seen the true declaration, he allowed it. Okay, he allowed it. Then the goods were imported to India. Now, either the importer, the passenger, will be allowed to take the goods, or if he has passed already, the someone who is belonging to that passenger, they can come and collect those goods from the particular cargo. Okay, then the declaration of the goods bought in the absolute necessary, if the goods are not declared under section 77, right, if the passenger fails to declare about the specification of the goods, while whether they are dutiable goods or not, if he has not specified in the declaration form, the passenger cannot subsequently claim it, right? If suppose he bought certain goods, one passenger, he declared each and everything, though those were prohibited goods, but custom authorities might have allowed it. Okay, allowed it. And now you have a right, once it is allowed, you can receive it. But suppose you are not mentioned in the declaration form, and custom authorities, if they have allowed, if they are received in India, you can't receive it from there, because when they see it, these goods were non-dutiable goods, and these are not mentioned in section 77, which is a declaration form. So hence, the subsequent claim that benefit under section 80 and the goods are liable for confiscation. Regulation in respect of baggage, that is section 81. Since the provision in respect of baggage are complete code of themselves, it desirable to supplement detailed procedure wherein necessary with the rules making power. therefore provides that Central Board of Excise and Custom may make regulation in the following matters. Okay, the Central Board has made a regulation related to baggage, like providing for manner of declaration, the content of the baggage, providing for custom examination, assessment to duty, clearation of baggage, clearance of baggage, then providing for transit, transshipment of baggage from one custom station to another custom or the place outside India. Now, when you do any kind of a baggage, there has to be certain rules, right? These all rules are mentioned in section 81, right? Oh, they know about baggaging, duty-free goods, non-duty-free routes, goods. Okay, after that, what are the rules for it? It provides about, first of all, declaration about the content of any baggage. So whatever you are having a baggage, luggage, which you are importing, that luggage or a baggage should be declared in a proper content. Everything should be returned on that particular baggage. If you leave anything, it will be a great mess or a problem for you. Similarly, it should providing for custody examination assessment, right? There should be providing of custody. A custom authority should have a custody of those goods. They should hold in their custody the possession of the goods for some time. Then examination. They have a full right to do an examination as per section 81. If they found any kind of misrepresentation has been done by the person or the importer, if they found that there might be some fraud, so they have a right to do a detailed examination. Then assessment to duty. Now they can verify how much goods he is importing and what amount of duty he is going to pay. If they found that, in sometimes what happens that a customer may tell that he is importing only some 10 units or he is importing some 15 units, but in fact, in actually, when it is opened, the baggage, when it was opened by the custom authorities, they found that there was not 15 units, there was double, there was 30 units. And they will try to have an assessment of a duty by matching with what he is actually having in the baggage. Then after all, like when all things are correct, they will do a clearance of the baggage, right? When they do examination, assessment, content, when they will see it, they will do a clearance. Clearance when it is done means the job is done. When the custom authority has done a clearance means the importer can easily get his goods. Now providing for transit or transshipment of baggage, they will provide a transit, okay, and transshipment of baggage from one custom station to another, right? The goods might be like moving from one custom station to another custom station. These all things are even provided by the custom authorities and even place outside India. When he suppose exporting goods, the goods will go to some other custom station outside India. There also the help will be provided by the custom authorities. So in exercise of this power, the Central Board of Excise and Customs has prescribed the baggage declaration form. So as we have seen in the earlier part, that baggage declaration form is compulsory, right, as per section 76. So the importer has to fill that detail, in detail, the baggage declaration form with his own signature, and has also made regulation for the transit of unaccompanied baggage from the custom station. Has made even compulsory to follow the unaccompanied baggage where either they are receiving before the importer or before the importer arrives, the goods are arrived in India, or after he arrives. For such unaccompanied goods also, there has to be a declaration by the custom station of arrival at the different stations, like particularly at Mumbai, Delhi, Calcutta, Madras, Bombay, Trivandrum, Hyderabad, Kochi, right? These are the main places. To any other of the aforesaid custom stations, right? Here, anywhere you can go, the full custom stations are providing you a lot of help in the nation.